The universe began not with a whimper, but with a bang. Everything in this universe and the universe itself came into existence because of the commonly told Big Bang. It all started when in 1922, a Russian meteorologist, Alexander Friedmann, proposed that the universe might be expanding. In a very rare blunder, Albert Einstein, when came to know about this, rejected his theory, and with his erroneous calculations, proved him wrong. 5 years earlier, Einstein had published the static model of the universe and was very convinced that it was correct. He claimed Friedmann's theory to be violating the conservation of energy. After 8 months, however, Einstein admitted his mistake and published a retraction. The equation of general relativity allows for the possibility of an expanding universe. Today, this Big Bang theory is an accepted idea of cosmology. The expansion of the universe was first observed by Vasto Silfer in the early 1920s, and in 1929, Edwin Hubble, who had access to some world's largest telescopes, gave the Hubble law. According to it, every distant galaxy is moving away from each other with a velocity proportional to its distance. The farther away a galaxy is, greater is the velocity with which it moves away. Then Arno Penzias and Robert Wilson detected a background of microwave radiation known as the Cosmic Microwave Background, CMB, radiations today, coming to Earth from all the directions. It was an afterglow of the primordial hot and dense fireball. Today, with the data collected from the Cosmic Background Explorer, COBE, satellite fits perfectly with the Big Bang, and that it accounted for the light nuclear isotopes like deuterium, hydrogen, helium-3, and others. The Big Bang theory is a success, but in its traditional form as it was proposed, is incomplete. Though it's called the Big Bang theory, it does not tell us anything about the bang. It's the theory of what happened after the Big Bang, describing how the universe cooled and expanded, and how matter formed different stars and galaxies. The theory does not tell us anything about the underlying physics of this explosion. It not even mentions what caused the Big Bang, what banged, why it banged, and what happened before the bang. The inflationary cosmos explains this, and we will discuss the physics behind it in this video. Could the Big Bang have been caused by the gigantic bag of TNT, or a thermonuclear explosion? Or maybe a gigantic ball of matter collided with a gigantic ball of antimatter? In fact, none of these events are responsible for the Big Bang and start of our universe. The Big Bang had two very special and distinct features that differentiated it from any typical explanation. First, on large scales, Big Bang was far more homogeneous than any other explosion. We must clarify you first while discussing homogeneity that the universe is inhomogeneous in many ways. New York differs from California, and so are the stars, galaxies, and the other clusters scattered through the space in a complex pattern. Cosmologically, these are all small scale. On a large scale, like if we divide the universe into cubes of 300 million light years or more, we would find that each cube resembles the others in all its properties like mass density, light output, etc. The biggest evidence of it is the cosmic microwave background, CMB radiations, and data from COBE's satellite. We would need a brief history about the cosmic microwave background radiation to explain the uniformity of our universe. The early universe was boiling and dense, and it would rip apart the electrons from the atoms, which resulted in a plasma that filled the space. This plasma was very opaque, so the protons making up the cosmic microwave background radiations were absorbed and re-emitted constantly. After about 300,000 years, the universe cooled to form a transparent plasma of neutral atoms. Since then, the photons have traveled on a straight path and provide us an image of a universe that was 300,000 years old. Normally, such uniformity is easy to explain because anything comes to a uniform temperature when left undisturbed for a long time. But in the Big Bang theory, the universe develops quickly, leaving no time for the universe to evolve and uniformity to be established. For the sake of discussion, let's pretend that the universe contains blue creatures, each having a furnace and refrigerator, and have the task to create a uniform temperature. These little creatures would then have to travel with nearly 100 times the speed of light to make the temperature uniform. since neither antimatter nor sticks of dynamite could travel faster than the speed of light, they cannot account for its uniform temperatures. The classical form of Big Bang postulates that the primordial fireball filled the space from the beginning. By assumption, and not because of any physical process, it was assumed that the temperature was same everywhere. We know this flaw as the horizon problem. The second special feature of the Big Bang, which is very difficult to imagine arising from a standard explosion, is a remarkable coincidence called the flatness problem. This problem concerns the pinpoint precision which we must specify the mass density of the early universe for the Big Bang theory to agree with reality. First, we need to review a little vocabulary. If the mass density of the universe exceeds a value called the critical density, then gravity will be strong enough to reverse the expansion eventually, causing the universe to recollapse into what is sometimes called the Big Crunch. If the mass density is less than the critical value, the universe will go on expanding forever. We know the ratio of the mass density to cosmologists by the Greek letter omega. General relativity implies that the geometry of the universe is Euclidean only if omega is 1. So an omega equals 1 universe is called flat. Omega is very difficult to determine, but its present value lies somewhere between 0.1 to 2. That seems like a broad range, but consideration of the time development of the universe leads to a spectacularly unique point of view. Omega equals 1 is an unstable equilibrium point of cosmological evolution, so it resembles the situation of a pencil balancing on its sharpened tip. The phrase equilibrium point implies that if omega is ever exactly equal to 1, it will remain exactly equal to 1 forever. Just as a pencil balanced precisely on end will, according to the laws of classical physics, remain forever vertical. The word unstable means that any deviation from the equilibrium point in either direction will rapidly grow. If the value of omega in the early universe was just a little above 1, it would have rapidly risen towards infinity. If it was just a smidgen below 1, it would have rapidly fallen towards 0. For omega to be anywhere near 1 today, it must have been extraordinarily close to 1 at early times. For example, consider 1 second after the Big Bang, the time at which the processes related to the Big Bang, nucleosynthesis, were just the beginning. For omega to be anywhere in the allowed range today, omega must have equaled 1 to an accuracy of 15 decimal places. This is mainly known as the flatness problem. These were some problems with the classic Big Bang theory. The property of Big Bang are very special, and the laws of physics provide a mechanism for this sort of bang. We know this mechanism as cosmic inflation. The inflation hypothesis gives us a decent explanation of why is the universe expanding from the Big Bang. It puts the bang in the Big Bang. After inflation, the universe would have continued to rise like the Hubble expansion we see today. It answers 4 main questions: the problem of smoothness, flatness, missing monopoles, and expansion. To solve the problems of smoothness, flatness, missing monopoles, and expansion, the universe needs to expand by a factor of 10 to the power of 25 in less than 10 to the power of minus 30 seconds. For this, the energy density of the vacuum during inflation needs to be vastly stronger. Also, the universe stopped inflating at some point to make way for regular Hubble expansion. For this, the vacuum energy would have to drop from a very high value to zero. To understand this, we need some quantum physics, and here quantum field theory, QFT, which explains how a vacuum can have energy. The universe is filled with these quantum fields, and it has a field strength. This field strength determines how much force a quantum field exerts on other fields and particles present. For example, a magnetic field, the stronger it is, the more it pulls or pushes a fundamental particle in just an oscillation in this field, a little packet of energy held by the field. If the energy in a quantum field is in the form of particles, and if space is expanding, as in our universe, then that energy gets more and more spread over time. As these particles get dispersed, the energy density becomes low. A quantum field contains an intrinsic amount of energy, even without particles. In that case, it always tries to drop to the lowest energy state. and that means it loses all energy besides what is bound up in particles. If we take an example of a magnetic field, when we take away electric current that created it, the magnetic field will quickly fade away. A field doesn't jump to the lowest energy state instantly. It does it at one step at a time. If we graph quantum field potential energy versus field strength, it might look like this. If the field finds itself at a high energy state, it would roll to the minimum and stay there. The lowest energy state, PF, the field is called its vacuum state. But sometimes the energy contained by a field has a more complex relationship with field strength. The field can have a local energy minimum, and if a quantum field finds itself near such a local minimum, it would roll down to the bottom and get stuck there. It would have a large amount of energy but no particles. We call this a false vacuum. A temporary one, as the name suggests. It gives us exactly the constant energy density needs for inflation. This field was called inflation field in the early universe because of very high temperature. This inflation field had a high field strength. It loses strength and energy with the cooling of the universe, but is stuck in the local energy minimum. The universe keeps cooling, but the inflation field can't lose more strength. It would have to cross the local energy barrier to do that. Being stuck at a constant and very high energy density, inflation takes hold and its exponential nature blows up the universe, rendering it empty and cooling it to a lower temperature. Or we can say it supercools the inflation field. It remains in a vacuum state that doesn't match its temperature. Inflation would go on forever if the inflation field stays stuck. But the quantum fields have a tendency to randomly fluctuate to different values, as it is explained in the Heisenberg's uncertainty principle. And somewhere in the inflating universe, the inflation field fluctuated to the other side of the local minimum barrier. It quantum tunneled there. And on the other side, it sees a deeper, truer minimum, the true vacuum state, and starts losing energy to reach there. Inflation stopped at that point, and the entire inflation field surged down in energy. The energy that existed in the inflation field doesn't just go away. It remains there, but in the form of inflation particles. It's like the entire floor of the field shifted down in space and converted into a stack of inflation particles. These particles are very unstable and dispersed their energy into other quantum fields and decayed into quarks, electrons, etc. The vacuum of inflation is converted to a hot ocean of particles. The universe was re-thermalized by this process. This process heated the universe to the extreme energies that we expect existed right after the Big Bang. To this point, the universe should have evolved as the rest of the Big Bang story predicts. While it may be too early to say that inflation is proved, I claim that the case for inflation is compelling. It is hard to even conceive of an alternative theory that could explain the basic features of the observed universe. Not only does inflation produce just the kind of special bang that matches the observed universe, but quantum fluctuations during inflation could have produced non-uniformities, which served as the seeds of cosmic structure. These non-uniformities can be observed directly in the cosmic background radiation, with an amplitude of about 1 part in 100,000. So far, the measurements of the spectrum have been beautifully consistent with the predictions of inflation, although it must be admitted that non-uniformities created by cosmic strings are also consistent with the observations. Cosmic strings, however, cannot explain the large-scale homogeneity or the flatness of the universe. While the case for inflation is strong, it should be stressed that inflation is really a paradigm and not a theory. The statement that the universe arose from inflation, if it is true, is not the end of the study of cosmic origins. It is, in fact, closer to the beginning. The details of inflation depend upon the details of the underlying particle physics. So cosmology and particle physics become intimately linked together. While I cannot see any viable alternative to the general idea of inflation, there is still much work to be done before a detailed picture is established. And I suspect that there is room for many new important ideas. So what do you think about the theory of inflation? Does it really give the answers for inflation? Did you know about this theory before? Let us know in the comment section below. If you liked our video, please like and subscribe and share it. We will keep answering your questions in the coming future.